Hello, it's Yoldi Battle Reps bringing you another Mordheim battle report. This time it's going to be Beastmen versus Undead, and I think this will be the third battle each warband has fought in total. And the Undead had a Catacombs map, which meant they could choose a scenario. They've gone for Wisdom Hunt, which is pretty cool, and we got four pieces of Wisdom as well. So there's one there, basically just kind of in the four corners, apart from one is a bit further forward. And I'm just going to do a summary of the warbands first of all, and then we'll get on with the match. So my beastmen are led by a chieftain called Black Philip. There he is. And a shaman called Vile Tongue. So Black Philip's got a club and a sword, and Vile Tongue's got two clubs. This is a Centaur called Rammer with two clubs. I've then got two Bestigors who are denoted by shields. They don't actually have shields, but it sort of sets them apart. And they've, funnily enough, they've got two clubs as well. And one of them is hardened. What's this guy? Then I've got a Gore who became a hero last time. And he's got two clubs. And I think he got a skill. I'd have to check what the skill is. I've got a note of it somewhere. Two Gores with two clubs, and then one Gore with one club on his own henchman group. And then five Warhounds. We've got another one after the last battle, which is the most you can have. And these are pretty awesome models. I don't know. I think they're actually Warhammer models.
They're the old Warhammer, Chaos Warhammer models.
Ah, right, cool. Yeah, nice. So that's my warband. I've got 14 members. And we'll have a look at Dan's Undead now.
So in my Undead Warband, I've got Vampire. It's the Isabella von Karsten model, and I have just called her Isabella out of respect because I just love this model so much. She's pretty awesome actually. She's got heavy armor and a shield, a sword and a bow, step aside, and plus one attack. So she's got three attacks, parry and step aside, which is quite hard. I've then got my Necromancer, who's called Sigvarch. He's got, despite of what he's holding, he's got a free dagger, a helmet, and a sword, and he's got two spells: Death Vision, which makes him cause fear, and Spell of Awakening, which is kind of cool because it means if one of his heroes dies, I get him as a zombie, which is cool, but it's relatively limited use. Then got three dregs. This one is called John Dunn. Got a two-handed weapon. I need to paint these ones really, but never mind. He's got double-handed weapon, helmet, and light armor, and he's got step aside. So he's pretty good. I've then got this guy who's got a buckler, a sword, and a helmet, and I can't remember what a buckler does. I think it gives him parry. I think he can parry two
Something
things.
to do with parry,
So I think
yeah.
he's got two parries basically, and he's got one plus strength as well, so strength four. This is a new dreg from the last time I played. I was able to afford another one. He's got what he's actually wearing, which is a shield, a sword, and a helmet. Nothing else because he's not earned anything yet. Three ghouls called the Brain Gobblers. They've got plus one strength, so they're strength four. Two zombies, which are just as they are because they can't level up. Three dire wolves, same, they can't level up, so they're all the same. I have actually got an awakened zombie, which is an orc biggin, which has got an axe and a sword. So he's actually pretty mental, really. He's a bit slow, but he's actually pretty hard. So that's cool. That's all of them.
We've deployed and rolled for the first turn, and the beastmen have got the first turn. And basically, I've just lined them up along here,
Yep.
and Dan's done pretty much the same.
We'll show where the waystone is as well, too.
Yeah, I've done that already. Yeah, although I suppose you can get a better view. You can sort of
The little
see
green counters
one
on the
there,
waystone.
one there, one there, and one there. Okay, so in my first turn, just a bunch of moving up basically. Beastmen are really fast.
Yeah,
So this flag
ridiculously
has come
fast.
all the way up here. And then even my foot guys, they can march 10 inches. I've got both pieces of Weirdstone. He's got that one. When you get it, I think we think you have to stop. You can't then retreat or anything.
That's what we've said anyway, so it's protected
Yeah.
both. And we've said that beasts can't carry it, so
Yep, so.
warhounds and dire wolves can't
Yep.
carry it.
Yeah, because that's kind of stupid if they can. And it does say warriors, and
Yeah.
don't think they should be able to. And then I cast a spell with the Shaman on the Gore, who's just one single henchman. And it went off, and it gave him... I chose plus one toughness, so toughness five. Okay, so yeah, undead, same, obviously not quite as fast as beastmen for the most part, although direwolves are pretty fast. So they've advanced as much as they can. They've got that weird stone just out of range to get this one. The vampire's coming up there, Isabella, to get that piece. Direwolves close behind, and Necromancer hasn't moved, is that right?
We can move over here. Oh, he's one away from them.
Yeah. And obviously there's big in there as well, trudging along.
Yep.
So, yeah, I tried to cast Fear, and it didn't go off.
Death Vision is called.
Oh, sorry, yeah. Death Vision, which causes Fear. Yeah. Cool. Okay, so it's the end of my second turn. There's not a lot for me to do. I've got no ranged attacks, and I've already cast my one spell. So, I've just advanced up. I probably would have been in range to charge with at least a Centaur against those guys, but didn't want to send him alone, obviously. So everyone is sort of catching up now, and these three are just by the building, and the vampires are around the corner from them. So it's on to undead. Oh, in terms of the weird stone, this guy is trying to catch up, and the other one I've sent back here. Don't know if that's a good idea or not, but I figure I can do with one less guy and hopefully definitely keep that piece of weird stone. Right, so undead, end of their turn, bit of tactical manoeuvring here. We've got over here, the guy with the weird stone is a dreg, so he can march, he's gone all the way back there. And then his brave zombie comrades have chosen to sacrifice their lives to the ravenous beastman horde to tear them apart. In other news, got the vampire, got that weird stone, and actually could get it and take a pot shot, one of my besticles, but didn't do anything. And then she's got her loyal hounds coming round as well. This quick turns because there's nothing.
There's no shooting
to speak of. And yeah, you failed to cast your spell again, didn't you?
Yeah. And I failed the shot as well.
Yeah. Beastmen, I've charged the two zombies at the front there with the. I think that's a Bestigor. Warhound there, Centaur, who got frenzied this turn, awesome. Yeah. And
another
Warhound. Yeah, this guy's bringing up the rear. I had to bring Black Philip over there, I think, because I needed leadership for these guys, potentially for Fear. But I think he's actually only going to affect that Warhound, so I don't know if it's worth it. It's only 6-inch range, isn't it? And then I decided not to charge those direwolves, and instead I've sort of formed a battle line by this building in front of these three undead monstrosities, and my guy with stones is chilling about there. So it's just combat now. And at the end of this combat, the Bestigor easily killed the zombie, and I attacked next with the Centaur, who basically he's frenzied, he's got two clubs, and Centaur's have an extra attack as well, so he had four attacks at strength 5 because he got plus one strength in the past, and he only managed to knock down the zombie, which sucks. That's really annoying. And that's it, that's the end of combat, so on to undead. And so undead have charged with a ghoul, the big one, and zombies or a dreg. Against these three. The vampire came around the building and tried to shoot at my hero Gore, but missed. We've got the ghoul just hanging back there. Oh, actually, one of the direwolves could see this Bestigor just about, so it's charged through and got this Bestigor behind as well.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
Yeah, and these other two have come behind.
And then on this side, the zombie stood up, he attacked last, and the ghoul has charged this. Wow.
Yeah, so a lot of combat going on now.
Yeah.
And the necromancer, quite importantly, now causes fear.
Yeah.
Right, it's the end of that combat phase. And what I was hoping was, okay, I'm sort of getting trapped here and about to be crushed by these wolves, but I'm beastman, so I might just kill these guys and I can charge wolves. But no, my Bestigor is dead, killed by that wolf. This guy's still locked in combat. Stalemate here.
stalemate with this
ghoul.
And then the fucking Centaur, another 4 strength 5 attacks, rolled.
We'll help!
Yeah, I'll just fill my pipe!
And then with his wounding hit, he just stunned it, which becomes knocked down. For fuck's sake.
Right, and the Warhound, although it was... I think it hit on sixes, but it didn't wound him. So, it's all gone to shit.
Everything's turned from gold. It's just shit!
Right, so it's my turn, like 4 or something. So I've got quite a few charges off. Black Philip the Chieftain's charged into... He was over there. He's charged into this wolf. And my Warhound is charged into another wolf. I've got... This is my hero Gorse charged into this dreg. And a Warhound helping out against that ghoul. And I think Bestigor helping out against that
wolf. Yeah, all you've got to do is wound this zombie, he's dead.
This guy's probably not going to do much if he's over there. And this guy's still out the back. Right, end of combat. What a bunch of fucking So basically, okay, well, over here, I finally killed that zombie, only because he was on the ground. So I think I hit automatic something, I can't even remember. But he's dead. Then this ghoul is still alive and knocked down my Warhound. Okay, this guy did alright, he killed the dreg. And he's my hero, Gore, so he gets experience with that, that's pretty good. And then Black Philip only managed to knock down this direwolf. Stalemate here. And my Gore, who's I think he's the lone henchman group, he has been knocked down, so he's going to die next turn. Alright, back to the brawl. Undead turn, whatever. Vampire charged my hero Gore and the ghoul as well. Biggin charged a Warhound. And a direwolf got in against Black Philip. What? And over here, nothing. I think you just got a ghoul, haven't you? Yeah, it's getting messy. This is not looking good.
Well, we'll see. You know what the rolls are going to happen.
Yeah. Right. So, it actually didn't go as badly as I thought. Black Philip took out one of the dogs. Another stalemate with these dogs against each other. The vampire fucked it up.
Critical as well.
Critical hit and then just rolled badly on the injury.
Like a 1 or 2.
Yeah.
And the ghoul couldn't do anything either.
Over here, just a stalemate. Yeah. Alright, so it's my turn and I can't rout yet. I've only lost 2 guys.
Yeah.
Hello again. My turn. I have charged in the Bestigor, who has actually killed 2 zombies so far. Yeah. Zombie Slayer. I've put the Centaur out of the way just because there's a small chance he could die, and he's going to level up if he survives anyway, even though he didn't kill anyone. I don't want like the vampire turning around and charging him or something. So these guys are just staying out of the way. I'm probably going to rout soon because I'm going to lose 2 more guys now. Okay, so my champion of this matchup so far is this hardened. What's his name? I'll find out. It is. Gouger, the Bestigor, and he killed the ghoul, so he's killed 3 people so far.
Yeah.
Pretty awesome. And it's really helped that he's immune to fear as well, he's hardened. But over here, Black Philip just couldn't do it. He fluffed his rolls against the wolf, direwolf, and then my hound knocked down the direwolf. Predictably, the vampire killed my hero Gore, and the orc Biggin killed the wolf. So Dan's going to have to take a route test now because he's lost more than quarter.
I'm not going to voluntarily route, I'm going to take a test.
So go for it then.
Pass.
Send pass, right. Oh dear. Okay, so basically it's just all going on here now. We pass the route test, rally test rather, and Black Philip, you're in way over your head. Look at this. It's got a wolf, a ghoul, a vampire, and another ghoul behind him. Oh shit. And the big one is going to attack this, he's charging to my hound as well. So, yeah. Fuck. But Black Philip's got a bit. Obviously, he only killed 1 guy, isn't he? So. Yeah. Okay, so the vampire fluffed it again and got a
exactly the same, actually. I think it was the critical.
And roll the two.
Two rolls on the injury table and roll two twos. Yeah. So the ghouls finished the job, which is annoying. The vampire didn't get experience for that. But Black Philip is dead, and so is that warhound. So I'm not going to bother rolling on the route test. I'm just going to voluntarily flee, because I'm just so gutted that Black Philip died. And that's the main reason.
Yep.
Pretty brutal battle there.
It was quite brutal. I was sort of scared at the start with when all that came around, but I thought, actually, I'm quite good in combat, because I cause fear.
Yeah, that helped you out a lot. Yeah. Obviously, again, the one guy that you didn't cause fear against just met on Rampage. Vampire's mental though. Just a bit of bad luck with the vampire, but I just overextended. I only had a small band of warriors there, and you came round from both sides and they couldn't hack it. So yeah, we've still got two pieces of wisdom each.
Yep.
Yeah, but you get an extra piece of winning as well, extra XP and stuff.
Extra dice.
So we'll summarise what's happened after the battle in the text format now.